Have you ever wanted to generate passive income by investing in art, bonds, real estate, used commercial aircraft? Yes, that's literally an option. Then look no further, because Yieldstreet has your back. This company promises you the ability to invest in all kinds of alternative investments, and in this video, I'm going to put that claim to the test. Hey everyone, and welcome to FinTech. And in this video, I'm going to be reviewing Yieldstreet, talking about how they got started, going through their platform, and reviewing the different kinds of investments available, and finally offering my own opinion on these types of alternative investments. This video is made in partnership with MoneyMade.io, which is a platform that lets you discover, learn about, and invest in different types of investments. I'll have a link in the description if you want to check them out. So hit the like button and subscribe if you want, and let's dive right in. So first off, let's talk a little bit about Yieldstreet's background to see if they're actually legit. Yieldstreet has over 225,000 customers, and they've been in business since 2015. They have been featured in a few notable publications, including the Wall Street Journal, Bloomberg, as well as CNBC. And back in 2019, they were ranked the fastest growing financial services company by Inc. 5000. On their website, Yieldstreet says that to date, they have returned $600 million to their investors, both in principal and interest. Yieldstreet does offer a wide selection of investments, and on their website, they try to emphasize how carefully they vet these selections. This is very important because they're not just appealing to accredited investors. Those are investors who make over $200,000 a year or have a net worth greater than $1 million. Instead, they are also trying to appeal to unaccredited investors, which are just everyday investors who want to make a return on their money. This means that they are subject to strict disclosure requirements that they have to list on the SEC's website. Yieldstreet says that in total, they have vetted over $15 billion in potential investments, and out of that whole pool, they only picked 4% of those investments to actually feature on their platform. Now, the last point that I should make before diving into Yieldstreet's platform is that they're very much focused on generating passive income. If this were stocks, it would be akin to investing in dividend stocks as opposed to growth stocks, which try to grow your equity. That's just something to keep in mind as we look at the types of investments being offered. So now let's dive into Yieldstreet's actual platform. So when you first log in, you can see that there's 5 different tabs at the top of the screen. And we're going to start out by looking at the resources tab. Now there's a lot to go through here, so we're not going to look at all of it, but just right away you can see that Yieldstreet offers a lot of different resources to try to educate investors. And they claim that that's a big part of their vision, is actually teaching investors about these types of alternative investments. So you can see here they have these different asset classes like real estate, marine, art, legal, and commercial. And then they also have all these different articles talking about alternative investments. If you go to the very bottom of this page, they have these Yieldstreet Essentials, which are basically like the getting started guides for this website. If you wanted to, you could spend all day reading these articles. You can see that there's 37 pages of these here, so we're not going to spend too much time going into those. Additionally, under resources, if there's any questions that you might want to have answered, this is a good place to look. They seem to have a decent amount of FAQs on here, so this would be the first place I would go for answers. Finally, they have the blog, which gives a lot of updates on the company as well as the direction they're trying to go. So for example, if we go to this one here, we can see how Yieldstreet's funds have evolved over time, and they kind of give you some insight into the thoughts of the people running the company. So that's as much detail as we're going to go into resources for now. So let's go to the next tab, which is the raise capital tab. This tab is not actually focused on investors. It's instead focused on people who want to bring an investment to Yieldstreet to be crowdfunded. Now, while this section isn't directly relevant to investors, I do think that looking at their origination approach under this tab is a little bit enlightening. So if we click on that tab here, you can see that they have 3 different steps listed here. This just kind of gives you a peek into what Yieldstreet is doing in the background in order to offer the types of investments that we're going to look at in a little bit. So now let's move on to the Our Vision tab. This tab here is really just talking about what Yieldstreet is actually trying to accomplish by offering these investments. On this tab, it immediately becomes clear that their focus is on generating passive income as opposed to growing equity in some kind of asset. As we go through here, we can see that their goal apparently is to build wealth creation for different people, and they think that the way to go about doing this is by generating passive income as opposed to investing in, say, 401ks and ETFs and mutual funds. Now, obviously, you can generate wealth both through passive income as well as through generating equity in an asset, but what they're trying to illustrate here is just their general mission. Now, if we scroll down a little bit here, we can see why they think an income-based ecosystem is more helpful than a growth-based ecosystem. Basically, they list 3 major points here. The first is rolling maturities, which basically means that you're going to make investments that are locked in for a time period, and they're going to mature at different dates, hopefully reducing the amount of risk that you're going to face in the meantime. The next is unparalleled diversification. By investing in these alternative types of investments, investments like art or real estate, you're diversifying your money away from the stock market, which means if the stock market drops, hopefully those other investments won't also drop. The third opportunity they say is that there's opportunities across the yield spectrum. Basically, you can get really high yield, high risk investments, or you can get lower yield, lower risk investments. In reality, Yieldstreet's platform isn't big enough yet to offer the full spectrum, but this is a good goal that they're reaching for. Now, finally, if you go down a little bit more, you can really tell that this is kind of a tech-focused company. They talk about the investor journey. They also talk about minimizing friction, which are both terms that you see thrown around a lot in kind of the marketing slash tech industries. Finally, here, you can kind of see what kinds of offerings they have across the yield spectrum, as they said earlier. Now, these are kind of broken up into three major buckets here. The first is wallet, which is going to give you between a 0 and 4% return. Then you have funds for 4 to 8%. And then the highest risk as well as highest yield opportunities are going to be these individual offerings, which is high as 12% yields each year. Finally, like they do all over this website, if you scroll to the very bottom, they have all these different articles that you can read to try to learn more about the site. And I do appreciate that they have all these different things you can read up on if you want to get more information. So now let's move over to the How It Works tab. So this top part here is kind of just a recap of the vision, but if we scroll down, there's three different types of investment products that they're going to list here. The first are multi-asset class funds. These are funds constructed by Yieldstreet to try to get you a consistent yield over time. The next are individual offerings. And to use these, you have to be an accredited investor and you have to have a minimum of a $5,000 investment. These are going to give you in general higher yields, but they're also going to be higher risk, which is probably part of the reason that only accredited investors can actually invest in them. And then finally, the last option here are short-term notes. These are going to pay a higher interest rate than you would from, say, a treasury bond, but you're also going to be taking on substantially more risk. So again, you have to be an accredited investor, but in this case, the minimum investment is only $1,000. The rest of this page here is kind of stuff that we already talked about, how they analyze deals, their FAQ. So finally, let's get into the investments tab on this platform. So on this tab, right at the beginning, they have this get started button where they will actually take you in and start setting up an account for you. And we're going to do that, but let's first scroll down a little bit and look in more detail at these assets that they're offering. So in here, they have the multi-asset classes that we talked about earlier. And in this case, they're talking specifically about this new fund they have set up called the Yieldstreet Prism Fund. So if we open up that fund, this fund offers an 8% distribution rate. The fund is supposed to go until March of 2024 and the minimum investment is $1,000. Now we're going to talk about a little bit later some of the fees that Yieldstreet charges, but this 8% distribution rate is after those fees are already applied. So that's the amount that you would actually take home. Some of the advantages to investing in this Prism Fund as opposed to individual assets is they are going to give you a little bit more liquidity than those individual assets might. They also have the ability for, once you get those distributions, you can either keep them as passive income or reinvest them in order to generate more income in the future. Finally, in here, you can actually look into the fund's top holdings through this portfolio builder. And you can see that they have a mix of art, consumer, legal, real estate, and more consumer, with several million dollars invested into each asset class, as well as varying yield rates. So you can see that the highest yield rate looks like it's on legal at 14%, and that's 7.65% of the fund. And the lowest is going to be in art at 8.25%, and that makes up 9.18% of the fund. Now, obviously, these aren't static. These are going to change over time. But again, this is just useful to see where your money is actually being applied. And then finally, on this page, they just kind of go through the steps that would happen if you were to invest in this fund. So first, you add money to your account. Then you submit the investment to invest it in the Prism Fund, and it might take a few days to actually go through in case they stop taking investments at a certain point. And then finally, your investment will actually become active and it'll go into the fund. So now let's go back to where we were before on the investment page. The next area we can look at are those individual offerings that I talked about earlier. Now in here, here's just a couple examples. So for example, one here is Northern Virginia Office Financing. This is financing for a $12.75 million loan on an office building somewhere in Virginia. If I were to open this up here, it's going to give me, again, more details on this specific investment. So in this case, the interest rate is going to be 8.25% for 24 months, and the offering size is $4.62 million. This investment is still open, and only 33% of it has been funded. So if you're an accredited investor and this looks like an interesting opportunity for you, you could put money into this. Now, I made a previous video talking about Fundrise, which kind of offers similar deals to this. And if you're wondering about the difference between, say, this platform and Fundrise, Fundrise allows for non-accredited investors to invest in deals like this, while these individual investments are only limited to accredited investors. If you want to look more into the details on this investment, they have a whole write-up here. So they talk about who this borrower is. In this case, it's a real estate investment firm. You can see any kind of essentials in here. So what's the capital structure? What's the lender positioning? You can see highlights. So these are kind of customized highlights put up here by Yieldstreet that talk about why you might want to invest with this particular person. So in this case, they talk about the fact that there's collateral coverage, that it's an anchor tenant with the US government, etc. And And then finally, like they do on pretty much every page, they have resources which just try to educate you more on the process of investing with Yieldstreet. So again, let's go back to the investment tab. And if we wanted to, there's some other types of individual investments you could do here. For example, here's a supply chain financing offer I could look into. And then finally, let's go to the short-term notes. So the goal with these short-term notes is just to earn you enough income to beat, say, money markets or certificates of deposit. Now, as of when I'm filming this video, interest rates are extremely low, so that's not too hard to do. But if we look into here, the only short-term note they list here is a six-month note that's going to pay you a 4.5% interest rate. This is substantially higher than US Treasury bonds are trading right now, but it's also not as high as you could potentially get in other investments in other areas of the site. So now the last thing that I want to look at here is, what does it look like if you're actually setting up an account with Yieldstreet? So let's click getting started. The first question they're going to ask is, what are you going to do with this extra source of income? I'm not really sure what they do with this information. So let's just say we want to fund my next business venture and do a home improvement project. Click continue. Now they ask what asset classes you're interested in. Let's just say everything. We're interested in everything. So now they ask, what kind of investor are you? And then finally, what's the size of your total investment portfolio? This is the point where they're going to determine whether or not you're actually an accredited investor. So let's say that my portfolio is only $300,000. So not enough to actually be an accredited investor. Then at this point, they're going to ask you to enter your name, your email address and password and actually sign up for the website. Now, because the minimum investment in this website is $1,000, I'm not going to do that right now. But come back at the end of the video to see whether or not I do decide to invest in this platform. Now, one question you may be asking is, how can some of these offerings offer yields as high as 12%? Well, there's no such thing as a free lunch, and there's also no such thing as free money. Anytime you're going to get a high return on investment, there has to be some kind of drawback. In this case, there's two main drawbacks: risk and liquidity. The liquidity issue is pretty clear. When you put your money into one of these investments, it's going to be locked in potentially for several years. During that time, the market might start rising and you're not going to be able to pull your money out and put it into a better opportunity. So in that way, liquidity itself gives you increased risk of missing out on the overall market. The next major issue is risk. In April 2020, Bloomberg reported that $89 million of a Yieldstreet investment in marine finance debt defaulted, meaning they completely stopped paying payments to the investors. That was because the money that was lent to a fraudulent borrower. At the time, that made up 7.5% of their total investment portfolio, but it only made up half of their total defaults for the year, which were 14.1%. Now, just to give some context to that number, we can compare it to junk bonds. Junk bonds are basically bonds offered by companies that don't have good credit. Currently, the average junk bond default rate is 4% compared to Yieldstreet's 14%. So that's much higher risk than an equally illiquid asset like a certificate of deposit, and it's much less liquid than perhaps a high risk option like investing in stocks. So that's a review of most of the actual platform, but now let's look into how Yieldstreet actually makes money. Well, they make money primarily through fees. Yieldstreet collects on average 1-2% in annual fees on each of their investments. If you want to see more on these individual fees, you can see them in each of the individual investments pages. But in addition to these annual fees, there are also occasionally origination fees charged to the people offering the investment in the first place. You don't really have to worry about those because those wouldn't affect the investor directly. Now, for an example of how these annual fees might play out, we can just look at the Prism Fund, which charges a 1% annual fee as well as up to potentially 0.5% in annual admin fees for a total of 1.5% per year. That may not seem like a lot, but when you compare it to something like an ETF, that's actually a pretty high expense ratio. For example, the VTSAX ETF from Vanguard only charges 0.04% in annual fees, meaning that Yieldstreet's Prism Fund is charging 37.5 times more per year. When you compound that difference over a long time, it can make a really big dent in your overall returns. But that being said, there's also a lot to say for diversification. While you could diversify away from investing in purely stocks by buying cryptocurrency or real estate, there are some issues with both of those. With cryptocurrency, for example, there's still a pretty strong correlation to the stock market. So when the stocks move down, chances are your crypto is going to go down too. With real estate, on the other hand, there's a lot of management work that is involved in buying physical real estate. Or if you try to go with the option of buying REITs instead, those are again pretty strongly correlated with the stock market. Pursuing a purely passive income play with Yieldstreet could make it so that you have more money coming in when the market is down, even though it means you will probably be sacrificing some return when the market goes up. So what do I personally think of Yieldstreet? Well, at this time, I don't think I'm going to be using the platform. There just aren't enough offerings on the platform to really draw me in. Plus, I don't really need that level of diversification. I'm not going to be retiring or needing to pull money out of the stock market for at least the next 20 years, so I can weather a few drops in the market without it really affecting my finances. For someone slightly older, maybe in their 50s or 60s, I could see this type of diversification making more sense. Additionally, if you're the kind of investor who's more interested in generating passive income as opposed to growing their overall wealth, this investment could also make a lot of sense. As long as you're willing to take on the increased risk from these types of investments, as well as the lack of liquidity that you're going to face, the higher returns that you're going to get from this as opposed to a dividend paying stock could be worth it to you. But let me know in the comments what you think of these types of alternative investments. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.